Good morning, Olympia. We're here under the shadow of the Obama building. There's one of your new workers coming out, having a little walk here down in our very beautiful and picturesque little Burning Man here. We've got some new developments. It looks like we have a little entire island down here. Sorry if I'm not doing the best job of focusing. It's really sunny out, so all I'm seeing is just my own reflection in here. I think if I turn this way, it will be better. But we do have a... I never see anyone building it, not that I'm here that often, but it's interesting how it grows. We have quite a few new additions. I don't want to fall down there. So it does look like there is some activity, some action going on. Maybe there's like a lounge in there and people are just on their Wi-Fi or something, who knows. But once again, we've got our little Lego city here. A lot of these are popping up. I've seen a lot of them have immigrants, refugees. Maybe they're like new little refugee buildings just going up in every empty parking lot in the city, right? Who knows? Oh, hi.
Hi.
I'm just filming your thing. It's really cool.
Oh, no, you're fine.
Is that all right?
Yeah.
I'm putting it up on YouTube. People have been enjoying it.
Cool.
From all over the world, actually.
That's awesome.
So okay. I call it Little Burning Man.
All right. Building a bunker here.
Wow, that's really cool. In the shadow of the Obamacare building, they're building a bunker here. So this is wild. Once again, you see that they are refugees in their own country. These are two, what I would call Caucasian American males, and they look friendly and able-bodied, and that is not what I see coming out of the Obama building. So, you know, these are the people not getting hired. It's funny, I ran into a friend the other day and we went for a quick little drive and he said, shall we go downtown to the zoo, the human zoo, where all the people who were the farmers now live and all of their families who were thrown off land for the last 30, 50, whatever years, you know. The people who resisted, the people who kept coming west, you know, I wish my grandfather was alive. He was, you know, a rancher and, you know, his ranch was really big and wonderful. He'd been in World War II. He'd been stationed in Kodiak, Alaska. And, you know, the Deschutes ran through their property. I think that's one reason I love going down to that little river. And I went down there this morning. And, you know, he was fighting all of this. He was literally fighting the Rockefellers. In fact, I remember, like, actually Men in Black showed up at his ranch, once even, because his ranch was just south of Fort Lewis. You can even see it on the map. In fact, he lived off of something called Old Military Road, or Old Highway 99, you know, kind of like right in that area. And there were like testing missiles that would just like go into their property because they really did abut Fort Lewis. And he ran them off with his shotgun. You know, it's funny. He ran them off. And nowadays, probably that wouldn't happen. I don't know if there'd be like a standoff at Bundy Ranch. But, you know, they were not able to get toll roads in here. You know, the East Coasters were cowed. They had them sort of, you know, brought to heel, as Hillary Clinton has been known to say. And that was what I saw happen when the Evergreen State College came in, was it was a seeding of people who were brainwashed and were going to come out here and show the locals what yokels they really were, without understanding the bigger picture that people came to Washington for a reason. Back in the, my grandfather came here back in the 20s, you know, and my grandmother was already from out here, but you know, they were a Northwest family, although my grandfather wasn't. He was from the Midwest and hopped a train at a bizarrely young age, you know, and just came out, you know, go west, young man, that sort of thing. And became a fabulous rancher and was a star navigator as well. I think I've talked about him in another video. So it's just really disheartening to see that the people who are down here, you know, they're not, you know, like I said, like the woman from Pakistan in the pea green Mercedes driving around. Not that I think any of us want to be driving a pea green Mercedes around necessarily, but that, you know, it's this new replacement of people that I kind of show over and over again. Not enough. You know, once again, yesterday I was without my camera and saw so much. And yet, once again, it's also really scary to film it. Look at their beautiful view in the distance there. As the bunker has its view. So, all the power to whoever's trying to survive in this bizarre carcass of a place. The Clinton, Bush, Obama, and apocalypse, really from back to Kissinger, who just wanted to gut this nation. I still wonder why Kissinger isn't in jail, and talk about another foreign worker on our soil. You know, if I'm screaming about that, and somebody did write that in, I thank you so much, wonderful commenter. Was that KQ American lady who did that? There are just, you know, there are so many of you who are so incredible, and you really are an inspiration for, you know, keeping on keeping on and really showing the reality of the situation at hand, you know, so we can just move forward and hopefully be able to turn things around. The summit certainly was a blessing, was it not? Anyway, take good care, everyone, and hope to hear from you all. Bye.